Hello everyone. In today's lecture, we are going to see the classification of chopper. This is the topic of unit number 4, DC to DC converters and AC voltage controller. In today's lecture, we are going to see classification of chopper, operation of chopper, input-output waveform, effect of source and load inductance, and SMPS. Myself, Professor Amit Kumar Mishra, I'm having total 10 years of teaching experience and my domain expertise is of 10 years. Let's start with the first topic in this, classification of chopper. So chopper are classified into single quadrant choppers. In single quadrant choppers, it is of two type again, class A chopper and class B chopper. Second is two quadrant choppers. It is again of two type, class C chopper and class D chopper. And four quadrant chopper, which is subdivided into class E chopper. Mostly we can theoretically to understand, we can use SCR or any thyristor as a switch, but for practical applications, we go with power MOSFET or IGBT in place of SCR for used as a switch. Let's start with class A chopper. This is the circuit diagram of class A chopper. We have the input fixed DC. We have this chopper as a switch, which is going to use as a switch. We have this load. So when this switch is closed, at that time, this voltage is getting connected with the load. So we are going to get the positive output voltage. Current direction will be in this way. When chopper is off, at that time, this source will get disconnected from the load and we won't get any output. So the direction of current is positive and voltage is output voltage is also positive. So the graph we will get in first quadrant. When chopper is on, supply voltage is connected across the load. When chopper is off, V naught is equal to zero and the load current continues to flow in the same direction through FWD. The average value of output voltage and current are always positive. Class A chopper is first quadrant chopper. Class A chopper is a step-down chopper in which power always flows from source to load. It is used to control the speed of DC motor, motoring operation. The output current equations obtained in step-down chopper with RL load can be used to study the performance of class A chopper. This is the graph. Like we are using the SCR over here, the circuit you can see over here. This is SCR, so it is having the gate. Even though if we would have used MOSFET or IGBT, still it would have the gate. So we need to trigger that. So this is the gate pulse. Once it is triggered, at that time we are going to get the output current. And for that, we will be getting output voltage. During T on, we will be getting the output. During T off, we won't get the output. Next is class B chopper. This is the circuit diagram for that. We have the affixed DC source, diode. This is chopper and load. So let's see the operation of this. When chopper is on, E drives a current through L and R in a direction opposite to that as shown in figure. During the on period of the chopper, the inductance L stores energy. When chopper is off, diode D conducts and part of energy stored in inductor L is returned to the supply. Average output voltage is positive, average output current is negative. Therefore, class B chopper operates in second quadrant. In this chopper, power flows from load to source. Class B chopper is used for regenerative braking of DC motor. Class B chopper is a step-up chopper. This is the graphical representation. Again, we are using a chopper. Either we are going to use SCR, power MOSFET or IGBT. So we need to trigger the gate. Here we are getting negative current, whereas voltage is positive. So we will be getting the graph in second quadrant. Now as current is negative, so it has been plotted below the axis and output voltage is positive. So during T on, we are getting the output. During T off, sorry, this is T off. T on is when we are triggering it. So during T on, we are not getting the output. During T off, we are getting the output. So this is output voltage waveform. Class C chopper. If we see class A chopper, then it consists of a chopper and diode. If you see class B chopper, we have a diode and a chopper. If we combine these two, then means if we combine class A and class B, so we will be getting from class A as output voltage positive, output current positive. From class B, we will be getting output voltage positive and output current as negative. So we will be getting two quadrant chopper. This is the circuit diagram of class C chopper. Let's see the operation. Class C chopper is a combination of class A and class B choppers. For first quadrant operation, CH1 is on, or D2 conducts. For second quadrant operation, CH2 is on or D1 conducts. When CH1 is on, the load current is positive, the output voltage is equal to V, and load receives power from the source. When CH1 is turned off, energy stored in inductance L forces current to flow through the diode D2 and output voltage is zero. Current continues to flow in positive direction. When CH2 is triggered, the voltage E forces current to flow in opposite direction through L and CH2. The output voltage is zero. On turning off CH2, the energy stored in the inductance drives the current through diode D1 and the supply. Output voltage is V and the input current becomes negative and power flows from load to source. Average output voltage is positive. Average output current can take both positive and negative values. Chopper CH1 and CH2 should not be turned on simultaneously as it would result in short circuiting the supply. Class C chopper can be used both for DC motor control and regenerative braking of DC motor. Class C chopper can be used as a step up or step down chopper. This is the waveform for that. Means first chopper we have triggered. Second chopper we have triggered. We are getting the current positive as well as negative. So this is the waveform for current. And during respective period, when chopper 1 is triggered, at that time CH is on. When chopper 2 is triggered, at that time CH2 is on. And simultaneously we have D on, the portion which we are getting because of D1, and the portion which we are getting because of D2. Output voltage is positive. So this is output voltage waveform. Class D chopper. So class D chopper, we are getting output voltage and output current from one chopper as positive. In class D chopper, we will be getting output voltage as negative also, whereas output current will be positive. So this is the graph for that. This is the circuit diagram for class D chopper. Let's see the operation of class D chopper. When class D is a two quadrant chopper, when both CH1 and CH2 are triggered simultaneously, the output voltage V0 is equal to V and output current flows through the load. When CH1 and CH2 are turned off, the load current continues to flow in the same direction through load D1 and D2 due to energy stored in the inductor L. Output voltage V0 is equal to minus V. Average load voltage is positive if the chopper on time is more than the off time. Average output voltage becomes negative if T on is less than T off. Hence, the direction of load current is always positive, but the load voltage can be positive or negative. This is the waveform for that. This is, we have triggered CH1, chopper 1. Here we have triggered chopper 2. So in class D, we are getting the output current positive only. So we have drawn that on the upper side of the axis. Whereas voltage, output voltage can be positive or negative. So we have drawn in both the sides. So this is the output voltage. This is output current in case of class D chopper. This is class E chopper. So we are getting output voltage positive, negative, output current positive, negative. So this is four quadrant chopper also. So class E is also called as four quadrant chopper. Class E is a four quadrant chopper. When CH1 and CH4 are triggered, output current flows in positive direction through CH1 and CH4 and with output voltage is equal to V. This gives the first quadrant operation. When both CH1 and CH4 are off, the energy stored in the inductor L drives I0 through D2 and D3 in the same direction, but output voltage V0 is minus V. Therefore, chopper operates in the fourth quadrant. When CH2 and CH3 are triggered, the load current I naught flows in the opposite direction and output voltage is minus V naught, minus V. Since both output current and voltage are negative, the chopper operates in third quadrant. Next is effect of source and load inductance. The source inductance should be small as possible to limit the transient voltage. Also, source inductance may cause commutation problem for the chopper. Usually, an input filter is used to overcome the problem of source inductance. The load ripple current is inversely proportional to the load inductance and chopping frequency. Peak load current depends on the load inductance. To limit the load ripple current, smoothing inductor is connected in series with the load. Next topic is SMPS. It stands for switch mode power supply. This is circuit diagram or block diagram for that. It consists of AC input, rectifier, filter, high speed switching circuit. Then across the output again we have rectifier and filter. Basically, the operation of SMPS is depending on the switch which we are using. So there is no permanent connection between input and the output. Wherever it is required, the switch will be closed. So we can get the input, we can connect the input with the output and we will get the DC across the output. And when we don't require, then this switch will be off. So this will save the energy, power loss will be less and efficiency will be more. So it depends on the switching or switch circuit. So this power supply is called as switch mode power supply. We can design the switch mode power supply with the help of LM323524D. This is the internal structure of that. In this lesson, we have learned classification of chopper, effect of source and load inductance, and SMPS, switched mode power supply. Thank you.